sealed.
Oh.
We're gonna do an update with what Doug wants to know, which I'll say.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's not my fault, I just, well, I knew they were working, I didn't wanna hammer on them, but I knew Doug was gonna get, at some point.
Spent all day on them, so.
Yeah.
They'll do an update tonight first.
That's great, that's, yeah.
Seems to only be.
Yes. Well, we all, yeah, we all should matter, here, that's right.
Oh, well, just do it. Take it tonight, after we leave.
I know, I know.
See, welcome to my life. It's nice.
One of those days.
Three hours in the morning.
Just rather.
After I get here and things get out of control.
I don't know what I did.
Oh, I did, but then these were the newer, newest ones, so I'll be a little while, so we can start. Sorry, Kat.
Are we ready?
Yeah, I think so. Are you ready, Michelle?
Ready.
Do you have Derek on?
Yes, he's on here.
All right, I call the City of Roseland Council meeting to order Tuesday, February 22nd, 2022, at 4:30 PM. Stan, have a flag, please. Flag allegiance to the flag.
To the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands, a nation, under God, indivisible, for liberty and justice for all.
Can I get a roll call, please?
Councilmember Weiss?
Here.
Councilmember Shear?
Here.
Councilmember Cook?
Here.
Councilmember Brodean?
Present.
Councilmember Uren?
Here.
And Councilmember Adams?
Present.
Oh, and I'm sorry, Councilmember Gruber?
Yeah, I'm here.
The mayor?
Oh, sorry, Mayor Howes, geez. Sorry.
Present. Or do anybody, I don't have any agenda updates, does anybody have any agenda updates? Okay, our consent agenda this evening is checks and EFTs as follows. Accounts payable in the amount of $135,788.49. ACH accounts payable in the amount of, in January, $77,115.30, and February, $11,622.03. And then a total payroll for multiple situations of $76.06. And then the payroll breakdown is in your register there. It's a lot of payments to the federal government and the state catching up on different things that we were. Just normal payments, and I think we're behind a couple things as well with the treasure changeovers.
Yep.
And then we have the minutes from January 25th, the last meeting we had.
Make the motion to approve the consent agenda.
Second.
Just so you know, I'm taking my notes here. We had our annual USDA loan payments, which is one of the higher January figures, $42,000 for water and $18,000 for sewer. And then we talked about some past due retirement payments to the state, benefit payments, and then to the IRS as well. But I think we are mostly caught up. We're doing some reconciliation there. And then one of the payables also includes our annual insurance premium of $16,320.
So. Is that the EWC one?
Yeah.
Okay.
The risk
I was curious about that.
Yeah.
Okay. What is left? What is the USAID loan for right now?
Is that the water treatment plant?
The USDA one?
Yeah, there's two.
It's the
water and sewer debt.
Probably the bridge, if anything.
Is it the work on the bridge?
You know what? I'd have to double check, but probably yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, right.
I'm just guessing.
Yeah, just sort of curious what that loan was. If actually you look at transmission line, you talk about looking at USDA, what loans are down the road and things like that.
Any other discussion, Council? All in favor of the consent agenda, say aye.
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 Anybody opposed, say nay. In your name, virtual folk.
Mayor, just one thing too, and I've seen this going through this, but like Labor and Industries quarterly report, attention Amber Shallow. I've also seen attention to Mike Woodwell. If we can get those all changed, I know it's just a process, but. Just all the attention.
Not to speak for staff, but the state is not. not real receptive of making accurate changes.
I mean, that's fine.
Some of them actually want us to call the former employees to have them call them and tell them that they don't work there anymore.
And I'm sorry to even bring it up. So that's ridiculous.
We've sort of threw a lot of those, but yeah, there's still a few paying there.
It should even be from them. It should be from just the office.
It just should be the city of Roslyn.
They should just be able to designate who they want.
Yeah, that's crazy. But thank you. Thank you for trying. Not to be a pain.
It drives us all crazy.
Yeah,
we did get all the banking figured out, so I'm close.
Right.
Knows who works there.
That's a plus.
Yeah. Okay, so is Chief Bland on?
He is. I do not see him on here.
Is there any representatives from Quilm Roslyn Police Department? All right, Chief. You can come in here. Here you come.
Yeah.
Is he just going to... Are you guys co?
Yeah, co-presenting.
Do you want to, Corey?
Yeah, if you could come up.
Come up to there so everybody on here can hear you too.
Microphone.
Sure.
Tell him to grab his shirt. Okay.
He made it just like
that. Yeah, you can sit in up here so the microphone can catch up for the virtual folks.
Sure. So that resolution are we talking about, or what's on the agenda right now?
Well, the resolution is on the agenda. You can speak with that.
Okay. So this one is, so I think one of the challenges is that we have adopted a fair amount of code recently, or I don't know, Michelle, when the International Building Code was adopted, but it's been a while.
What? Yeah.
And there's portions of it that just haven't been enforced, right? And so I think one of the challenges in Roslyn is like nobody wants to have like the heavy hand. So the challenge is how do we kind of like make the city safer and balance enforcement? So this resolution, as Michelle drafted, I think is just that we're going to start trying to work towards like demonstrable and having people voluntarily like do their yard cleanup, keep the lawns mowed, remove places where embers would land, and then at some point get into figuring out how we do, you know, like enforcement. There's, you know, just ongoing big problems that aren't getting resolved. And so that would primarily be, you know, initially we talked about some ideas, and I think we would just come back to you with some ideas, but going around and assessing, like having a couple people on the fuels crew take the class to be a, you know, certified home inspector for fire, and then go around, and we could do it also with the conservation district, because they also offer the service. Just go kind of door to door and rate, like, this house is a green, this is a yellow, this is a red, which is the code that gets used, and then encourage people who have the reds to get to a yellows and yellows to get to a green. So that's that. And then the other thing that ties to this, and we're hoping to roll all of this out on the first Saturday of May, which is nationally, it's Community Wildfire Protection Day, is to talk to people about evacuations. I don't want to say evacuation routes, right? There's a lot of people want or asking about signed evacuation routes, but that's not really a thing for fire because you don't know where the fire is going to be or where the wind's going. So signed evacuation routes are more for flooding, that kind of thing. But we do want people to know what the various routes are, and we want people to know that there's a plan and that it's kind of widely known. And then we want to make sure that everybody's signed up for the county's Everbridge program, right, which you guys have been pushing out on the utility bills a couple times, and we should probably do some more of that, but that's going to be the key, because it's not in the event of evacuation, it's not the fire department that does that, that's law enforcement that does that.
And that's kind of what you guys will be at the market, discuss with people on other things.
Yeah, we have information for that.
So the, you know, a few months ago, we had the list of some code changes for fire preventative around the house.
Yep, that's on your March.
Yes.
Yep.
So
we have to hold
the public. Is that tied to the resolution then? And I think the only, I mean, we've tried to pass it many times, but the only thing we were waiting for was this, I think, the plant.
The plant list, which we have now. So, yeah, so it's that, our property maintenance code, which we've already adopted,
yep.
And then the WUI code, which we've also already adopted.
Yep.
So it's a combination of those three that.
So we ever get the plant list? So I think that was the only thing council wanted left was to look at that so we could pass it.
Yeah, so that's all on the agenda for the first March meeting.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay. Just seeing, I just wanted to, it seemed like it should be tied to that resolution. So
and it is. It's
okay.
It's named in that resolution,
okay.
So yeah.
And there's a public hearing.
Yep, we'll schedule the public hearing,
okay.
And then the final draft will be before you guys.
And that draft hasn't changed since the last time we sent out.
Besides the plant list, no.
No, because I've read through it, so I was just curious. It was
yeah.
Only the plant list that I was curious.
Yep. And I can send that out before too.
Okay.
That's fine.
Okay, great.
So I have a question. I did sign up for the Everbridge and like that. But what I'm wondering is there a plan for? I mean, some people don't have smartphones, and is there a plan? Is there any plan in the works for addressing their needs?
Well, yeah, two things. One, Everbridge will call landlines.
Okay.
Right. So you can sign up. You can put multiple numbers into your Everbridge account. But the other thing that we want to try to implement is the CERT model, the Community Emergency Response Team model, which is kind of a FEMA, I think it's FEMA, isn't it, Jeff, that
mm-hmm.
sort of started that. And so that's kind of like a, you know, think of a block watch, right? So, and I think this happens naturally here, but we should probably formalize it, is that in the event of an evacuation, you start getting that text, right? You think to yourself, oh, well, Don, you know, two doors down, you know, he lives at home and he doesn't have a cell phone, so I'm going to go check on him.
Yeah.
Right? I'm going to let him know. And so that's the CERT, which after this winter, right, kind of showed why we might want to have that just in general, right? So that when there's a significant issue, whether it's a long power outage or even a short power outage for someone who's on home oxygen or something, that we have people in the neighborhood that are going to go check on. And then the other thing that happens in an evacuation is law enforcement actually goes door to door. Right? So the hope is that everybody gets coverage.
Piggyback on this, and this might be too specific question, but you know, here's what I need to say.
So again, what we really want to do is get everybody that's a homeowner or whatever it is in Roslyn to be signed up for that Everbridge. Because anybody can do it. I mean, you could live in, you know, you could live in Kansas and sign up if you were curious about what was going on in a sort of model. If you were, you know, if you wanted to know. So yeah, we would hope that the homeowners would do that also.
We want everybody involved. Everybody to sign up who's got some property or.
Yep. Okay. And they did it.
Thanks.
We used Everbridge this fall to notify people of the prescribed fires. So people got a text and a call saying there'll be prescribed fire.
Everbridge is an app?
Mm-hmm. Everbridge is the name of the county. It's a, yeah, it's like a company that provides this service to the county.
Okay.
And it's run by the, you know, the advantage to it is that, you know, for a small town like us, right, no one's here. I mean, the vast majority of the time, right, no one's in the office all night long, all weekends long. So Everbridge, rather than us getting our own system, it's done by the county, by the company.
Okay.
It's a really easy sign up. Just Google it up, it'll pop right up your phone. Just register.
Yeah.
You go to Google or you go to an app?
You can Google it to find it if you want to.
Oh, okay.
So you can put Kittitas County
Yeah, the county's got a link.
It's on their website.
Okay. We have a, don't we have a link on our website now?
I don't know the answer to that. We can put one though if we don't.
It texts my gov, I thought.
Yeah, but I don't know if we have it to Everbridge itself.
You have an app on app store though. You can download an app.
No, you don't need to download an app. You just sign up.
You just go to the site.
Oh, and then you sign. Okay.
So that's the thing, is it doesn't need a smartphone. It's just.
Oh.
It's gonna send you a text and it's gonna call. Someone has a regular cell phone, landline, whatever. It'll call.
It doesn't text.
It does that.
Oh,
too.
It does text. Oh, cool.
You can sign up if you want. Text. Voice call or email.
Oh, okay.
All free.
And so you're just signing up for notifications, and because for some reason I've never heard of Everbridge, so I just signed up.
Sorry,
you know, no,
last night, but we sat here a couple times. I mean,
yeah. Well,
yeah.
I remember talking about it, but I just haven't signed up for it,
right.
So I haven't got adjusted to it. But
right.
Now I have to. So okay, so I'll
I don't
figure it out.
Think there's a way, Jeff. Is that, do you know enough about it? If there's a way to force sign it? Like we can't just sign everyone in Roslyn up.
Because you probably have to do a user agreement and everything.
And then there's, I think I said this to Gabby, right? Like, at the end of the day, if there's some, like, super serious thing or something, right, the State Department of Emergency Management can just draw a circle and ping every cell phone, every landline, everything. They don't really do that too often, but that can happen.
Yeah.
People will get notified. I mean, personally, I think the key is, the notifications are important, but I think people are going to get notified. The key is that people have a plan, that they're prepared, that they don't panic, and that they do things in an orderly way. And then most importantly, that we try to eliminate as many places where embers can land in town. Because, it doesn't have to be a wildfire. We could have just a regular structure fire on the wrong windy day in late August or early September. And things can start happening that are not good.
So the presentation in May, we're also going to have that information at the farmer's market. Like
and we're going to
do a mailer as well.
Yeah, okay. And then hopefully we're going to upgrade our website so it's got a lot of this kind of information.
Who's doing your web design?
Probably Katie.
Okay. Just out of curiosity. Got to change ours up eventually. I know we're using Mr. Wentz, and he's doing a great job, but...
Yeah. It's just convenient to have. I mean, what we want is just a super simple design template, and then we can update it, right? Because if you're counting on a designer to change everything, that's, I think, the challenge with the cities.
Then you got a third,
Right. And these days, you can use, any number of those things. Michelle, is the DNR contract on the agenda? So the other thing on your agenda tonight is another fuels contract with DNR. And so that's a roughly $110,000 that they're going to provide to us to do fuels mitigation and prep work in the rough and on the, continuing our prescribed fire, we call it fire infrastructure, right, but building out control lines around town.
Not in town work, just in the Roslyn Forest?
The DNRs is for in silvicultural lands. Yeah, they
gotcha.
They don't fund the, this particular program isn't funding the in town work.
Okay.
No.
It's not 14.
In town work came through FEMA.
Gotcha.
And then somewhat related to that is that we're going to be applying for a grant from the Suncadia Fund for Community Enhancement for a chipper, because one of the challenges has been renting a big commercial chipper. And that'll allow either us or Public Works to, designate a week in the spring or a week in the fall where people can set their brush at the curb and have it chipped. And then the chipper will be available. And part of the deal with Suncadia is that it'll be available also to for the same purposes.
And that's our budget, $105,320 that's on here. Is that the grant amount? Is that the amount that they're allotted us?
Well, I don't have the grant document.
There's a funding. Yeah, well, there's a payment on here. It's 300. Let's see. Yeah, it looks like $105,320.
That's the DNR one.
The DNR one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's what they're putting, allowing us to use for FireEye.
I believe so, but I'd have to look at it again here.
That's just through June 30th, at the end of their fiscal year,
okay.
And we'll do another application for after June 30th.
Great.
But so Mark and the fuels crew, Mark will be starting up March 1st to get some stuff organized, and then the crew will be starting to come on.
Great.
As they become available after that, so you'll start seeing work going on relatively soon.
Great. If you want to do it early, if you keep this dry, it'd be better, that's for sure.
Thanks, you guys. If you want to call.
Is there anything else? No, that's your line.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Hey, Tom, could you hear him okay?
Yeah, I was fine.
Okay. Okay, so let's get through the committees and commissions here real quick. I know that the planning historic preservation is tomorrow.
Well,
so.
No, we're canceling.
Oh,
we're going to have a special meeting when we get that back from OTAC. So.
Okay.
But I don't really have anything for them tomorrow. So.
The cemetery group?
Yeah. A little update. Yeah, we're happy to get a little update on what we're doing. So we had a meeting last Wednesday. One thing that the main project I think they're going to start on is they found the cemetery's capital project list, and I think it was done about 10 to 15 years ago. And we've accomplished probably 60% of the projects, and some of the projects probably aren't applicable anymore to some of the things in the cemetery. So they'd like to go through, and that is something that's been passed by council at some point. So they would like to go through and sort of take off what's on that list and update it, and then I would bring it to council and present it to council to get their support and pass it, or not pass it. But so that's going to be their next main step, is get their capital project list updated to what's current, what's been done, and then have new goals set for the future. So that they're working on that.
The water is on that one. The water,
yep, irrigation's on that. We did not get the grant this year, and so we'll try again for something else. We're going to do the engineering and planning. We have a meeting that, you know, we have a deal with the city that we've hired the city engineer, and we'll be paying his fees through the Heritage Club. And we are still going to do the design, so we'll be ready.
Yeah.
We have a meeting this week with Granite Engineering and Dick Watts and myself to sort of figure out what that is and how we get started, and we'll guide us through that process. And then you'll be invoicing the Heritage Club, and then we'll be sending you the payments for the city. And then also, just before Christmas, there's another